Hi, I'm Andrew, and this is Blaster Breakdown. Today, the Nexus Pro. This is a pretty handy blaster out of the box, but today I'll show you how I've got it firing 250 FPS and more, and yes, it's using a spring. This uses the expanded plunger tube mod with pieces designed by Andrew Tran and a few tactical pieces from Chicken as well. It now takes only short darts, but you can still swap the spring out to adjust your FPS if required. Before we start though, if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and don't forget to like if you enjoy my content. All right, let's have a look inside. Okay, so it turns out this is a really, really simple mod, mostly thanks to Andrew Tran's design of this piece in particular. So what this printed piece lets us do is replace the telescoping piece that fits over a couple of O-rings at the back here, and then telescopes inside the stock plunger tube, and that's where you get the slop. Instead now, this is all fixed in one piece with an O-ring that seals in the front of my new expanded plunger tube, and that then pushes the plunger all the way back the entire draw of the pump action, and means that we have that much more air in volume pushing our dart forward when we pull the trigger. So really, this printed piece and a plunger tube is all you need for this mod. There's also quite a small amount of shell cutting required. Really, it's this section here on both sides of the shell, of course, that takes the plunger tube, which sits at the back in the normal position, and then you can see I've sort of cut pieces here to hold the front of it so it won't move, and then of course the same on the other side. That's really all the shell cutting that you need for this mod. I've stuck with the original breech, and for an air seal I've epoxied my barrel in place here. So as mentioned, this is a 17/32 brass inside 16mm aluminium barrel, and it's about 10.5 inches long. I tried slightly longer, I tried slightly shorter. This was sort of the sweet spot. So that you can use as it is. This replacement piece I've actually glued in place, again with epoxy. There is a provision for a screw to go through to help hold it in place, but I'm never going to use this particular pusher for any other build, so why not just glue it in place. I've also added a bit of silicon padding there to take the force from the plunger when it hits, and this O-ring is from another Nexus Pro build that I didn't need it from. So that's all there is to that part. This plunger tube is acrylic. It's 40mm outer diameter and 2mm thick, so the internal diameter is 36mm, and it's 105mm long. I bought this one from AliExpress. It was only a couple of dollars, although it did take a couple of months to arrive here in Australia. I've got a wrap of Teflon tape underneath this O-ring and a couple underneath this one, and that gives me a nice seal at both ends. So putting this together, it's really straightforward. So one screw to hold the breech in. So now pump grip pushes the plunger back. It's held there by the catch. Then we seal the dart in place, and all this volume is available to fire our dart. The most important part is at the back, so that when the plunger engages the catch, you've still got a seal at the back here, and that obviously the plunger tube is long enough to give you a seal when the pusher is all the way forward. So the stock spring, if we have a look at it now, you can see it ends further forward than the end cap. So I ordered, again from AliExpress, a generic spring with a 15mm outer diameter. This comes in a 300mm length, and this has a 1.8mm wire thickness. I did get some that were slightly narrower. That would be obviously a weaker spring, so I might see how that goes if I want to drop the FPS down a little. But initially, of course, I'm going for high FPS, so this is the strongest one that I've purchased, and we'll see how that goes for us. Another thing I've done, which I've done on other builds, is remove one of the two magazine catches inside the adapter. There you can see the higher one is missing, only the lower one is visible, and I've got this release designed by Chicken. You can buy these on his Etsy store. I'll put a link to that in the description below. So that's a nice tactical option. He also makes a corresponding minimized magazine release piece. So sticking that in, that will sit like so. You might notice in here, you've got the inner side of the safety lock. I've snipped off the outer edge on both sides and just glued those in place there. So it doesn't do anything, but it fills up the hole. Another Chicken piece is this trigger. It's a hair trigger that's got a nice angle there for engaging the release. Stock catch. I like to retain the priming lock, so I'm going to keep this one in. But under here, of course, the trigger lock is gone, not least of all because this trigger doesn't have this latch at the front to engage it. So original trigger is gone, original mag release is gone, original mag adapter release is gone. I still do want this piece at the front. Sits like so. Original spring is gone, and I can put this together now. And I'll use the original grip and priming grip. There we are, simple as that. Now, replacement spring, that's the spring rest at the front. So I've got a bit of pre-compression loading that in. And I've got this replacement stock, looks pretty cool. And I've got this Blastertech printed rail riser, gives me a nice consistent look. And we can even stick on the original sights, why not? So, there we are. Okay, let's get some numbers now. So 10 inches of a 1.8 spring in the back and 10 worker Gen 3s. Okay, most seem to be around the 250 FPS, which is pretty nice. Okay, so out of interest, I've also cut 10 inches of a 1.4 spring, so this is a much lighter prime. I'm seeing if I can get around 150 FPS with a very easy prime. So again, 10 worker Gen 3s, let's see how we go. Okay, so one outlier there, might have been a soft dart, but as you can see, nice easy prime, giving us a sub 150 option for super stock events. Okay, here we are 50 feet from the target as usual. So again, 1.8 spring giving us around 250 FPS. I've got a magnified sight, it's on 2x magnification at the moment, and a bearing scar up front. So at this FPS, we could expect pretty tight groupings. Let's see how we go. Right, I think that's pretty nice. So there you have it. That's the Nexus Pro Expanded Plunger Tube Mod with internals designed by Andrew Tran and tactical pieces by Chicken and Blastertech. I'll link to all those in the description below. Please leave any questions and comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.